Selenium is something which has got many tools inside it. You cannot tell that Selenium is a single tool. It's not like that. Previously, when I first looked at this tool in 2006, and that was nearly 6 years from now, there were three components in this tool. The first component was known as RC, the second was known as ID, and the third was known as Grid. Okay, ID is still there. RC, many companies they use it, okay, and Grid is also there. Now, what's the difference between them? Well, Selenium IDE, if you talk about IDE, then IDE only works on the browser such as the Firefox browser. Only Firefox is supported by IDE. It is the simplest form of tool. It records, runs your applications and all, but you cannot make this tool work for complex applications. Right? To work with complex applications and to test your applications across multiple browsers, you need a tool like RC, which works on multiple browsers like Firefox, then it works on IE, then Chrome, then Safari, Opera and all are supported as well. Right? Now, Selenium, this tool will automate your Windows based application like a Windows based calculator or something like that. It will only work on browsers, right? And RC works on multiple browsers, ID works only on Firefox, and Selenium Grid, it is used for parallel execution of your test cases, right? And this was the scenario around in 2006, right? Now what happened was, Google started using Selenium. Like this is the story. The story goes like this roughly. And Selenium was initially made by a company called ThoughtWorks for their own internal testing purposes. So they kept this tool open source. It got famous. Google started using it. Now potentially RC had many drawbacks. RC is the tool on which majority of the people they work on, right? And RC had lot of drawbacks. So what happened was, Google along with ThoughtWorks, these guys, they came up with the new version which is known as WebDriver. Okay, now WebDriver as a tool, it also works on multiple browsers. It's an, you can say, it's the better version than, WebDriver as a tool, it's actually better than Selenium RC. It works on multiple browsers. And along with that, it has removed many drawbacks which were there in RC. IDE is still there, and for Grid, something known as Grid 2 has come up in the market. Okay. So these are things, they actually make Selenium very complex. Okay, Firefox is there, sorry, RC is there, IDE is there, Grid 1 is there, Grid 2 is there, WebDriver is there. So every tool is easy. Fine. I don't say that RC is difficult or ID is difficult to use. Fine. But these tools, all these tools out here, they are little bit vast. Fine. So if you're going for an interview, there is a probability that they can ask you a question on RC. They might ask you a question on WebDriver, or they might ask you a question on ID. So you need to be prepared with everything. And nothing is interrelated. It's not mandatory that you learn RC first and after that you learn WebDriver. Okay? Or you learn WebDriver first and then you learn RC. It's not like that. RC and WebDriver, they are completely independent of each other. You don't need to learn the prior version, that is RC, to learn WebDriver. Both these things are completely different. The APIs are completely different. Everything is different. So what happens is, some people who have knowledge on RC, when they go on to WebDriver, they are not able to understand a single line. It's like another tool, another different world for them, right? So this thing actually makes Selenium a little vast, and that's why I always suggest people that don't expect that you'll become a master of this tool in just a month or so, right? Just a minute, guys. I'll make this mute. Inspect, right? I hope everybody is able to hear me. And if you're not able to hear me, you can go to, I'll again repeat, you can move your mouse on the top of the window. You'll see a participants tab and a chat window. You can communicate me through the chat window, or you can click on the participants tab and unmute yourself and talk, right? So now, what is Selenium is okay. The components of Selenium is fine, right? Now another thing, what will you get out of this course? I told you that this is very vast, fine. So obviously in this online training session, I cannot cover so much. That's but obvious. I cannot cover IDE, IRC, WebDriver, Grid. It's very vast, fine. If you look at my website, qtvselenium.com, what we'll be doing is we'll be doing WebDriver with Java in this course. Fine. What about the other topics? I have a solution for that. And along with this course, you will get the access to 80 plus hours of videos on Selenium, which I constantly keep on upgrading. Fine. I have videos on Java, WebDriver, this thing over here. Then I have videos on, just a minute. Yeah. So I have videos on Java WebDriver. I have videos on RC, flash testing with Selenium, SVM, even database testing, Grid 2 and all. And lately I have added more stuff into this website. In just around 20-25 days, I have added applet testing with Selenium, then Chrome driver, IE driver and all these all things. And I have added new modules on the page object model framework design. Right. So there's a lot of things. I have made over 40 videos which are over 80 hours in duration. Okay. And I have still work is left, videos on continuous integration, Hudson and all are left, which I'm working on these days, Android driver and all. So this thing makes it very vast. Right. So what we'll be doing is we'll be studying WebDriver, Java and frameworks in this course. Maybe the JUnit framework or the TestNG framework. We'll try to make data-driven scripts or the hybrid scripts, the keyword-driven scripts in this. Fine. So let's start with the course, okay? And let me tell you the first thing. The first thing which you need to do is that you need to download Java. I hope everybody has installed Java, because to join this WebEx session, you need Java installed. Still, if you need guidance, you can just go to google.com. And you can just type over there download Java, and Java will be downloaded on your machine. Right, it's still not opening. Yeah. So you simply have to go here and type download Java. So this thing will just go to the first link which comes up, right? And you can install Java on your machine. In case you have a 64-bit machine, right? I'm not talking about 32-bit, but if you have a 64-bit machine, also download JDK. Okay? Also download JDK. The high level topics which I will be covering in the training, yes, I'll cover that, right? But before that, just let me tell you about the downloads. Now after that, you need to download Eclipse. Eclipse is like an editor for Java. Similarly, like there is an editor for C language, Turbo C is there, Visual Studios for C Sharp and all. Similarly, Eclipse is like a platform or an editor in which you can write the Java code, fine. So you simply search for download Eclipse in out here. Okay. Now before I move further on, I just need to ask you guys, right, before I move further, do you have any questions? Okay. Like somebody asked me a simple question right now. He asked me the course contents, high level course contents. Any other question? you can actually move your mouse to the top of the window, click on the chat icon, and in the chat you can ask me, yeah, Siddharth, tell me. Okay, you are using Flex based automation. Okay, I'll tell you. Flash testing, yeah, it's also Flash or Flex automation. How to do it with Selenium, I got your question. Right. Okay, any other question from anybody? You can move your mouse on the top, you can click on the participants tab, you can unmute or you can ask yourself, or you can click on the chat window and you can chat and ask. Right. Any other questions from anybody regarding the course, regarding Selenium, anything related to automation, right? Okay, mobile automation. Question being asked is mobile automation, right? Anything else? Automating auto-complete model windows. Okay, model windows like the server username password, right? Selenium versus QTP. Okay, paid tool versus open source tool. QTP is good. Yeah, anything else? Handling Ajax with Selenium. That's easy. You can do that. Yeah. Yeah. Ajax pop-ups and all. Yeah. Hudson. Yeah. That's what I was telling you. Continuous integration using Hudson or Jenkins. Fine. CSS menus. That I'll cover in the course. I'll cover CSS menus. Okay, I'll cover this. Right. Anything else? That's again dynamic things I'll cover in the course. Dynamic things. Yeah, that's a part of the course. Yes. IDs are generated at runtime. Dynamic IDs. Yeah, that's a very common problem which very many people face. Yeah. Framework design approach, yes, that will be covered in the videos itself. Sorry, in the training itself, framework design. Right. Anything else? Framework design and a very important thing, approach. Yes, that's the good word, approach. Okay, integrating Selenium, that's a very good question which very many people ask me. Selenium integration with QC, right. I'm going to make videos on this. Yeah. Whether I will cover RC or not. Well, I'll answer this right away. I'll not be covering RC over here. Why? It's, first of all, it's old. Secondly, many people who come to the training, they just want to learn RC. They just want to learn WebDriver. Okay. Database testing. Fine. Database. Right. Anything else? I'll cover each of these topics. Fine. I'll answer all your questions. Grid. Grid is there in the course here. Yeah. Can you verify PDF links without downloading the file? No, you cannot do that. You have to get it onto your system. Right. That's the safest approach. You can verify, but I don't know. Sometimes you know. Okay. Web services testing with Selenium dynamic trace. Okay. Can we upload thumbnail pop-up provided by Windows? Disadvantages of Selenium. I am not able to understand. What do you mean by thumbnail pop-up? Is it something like this? Hold on. Is it something like this you're telling? Siddharth? Yeah, okay. Upload window. Yeah, this is a very common question which people ask. Right. Okay, I'll answer these many questions and all. Yeah, how to use test SSL security websites, HTTPS, and how to do proxy configurations in WebDriver and all, I'll be covering. Look, why am I not covering RC is because who uses RC? Think of that. Okay. Who uses RC? Right? RC is used by companies who have already made their system in Selenium RC. They think that it is fine, it's stable, why should they move over to WebDriver, which is the latest version, they work in RC. Okay. Now, whosoever is starting the new development, they are starting in actual WebDriver. And most of the people who come to me, they come to me for WebDriver. So that's why I'm not covering RC, but what I will do is, right, I will be giving you videos, the access to the videos which cover a lot of stuff in RC. Right? Here is Selenium RC subject, and like everything is covered, pop-up handling, tab handling, security websites and all, HTTPS, proxy settings, everything is handled. Right? Now let's start with the questions. First of all, the question is course contents, high level description, what all we will be covering in the course. Well, the answer to that question is very simple. We first covering Java, especially the object oriented programming language. Now, why oriented programming language is because the whole concept of Selenium is on OOPS based. I'll be starting with object oriented programming in another 10 minutes, but before that I'll answer the question. This is the mistake which many people do. They directly jump over to Selenium without getting at the concept of programming. Strong, and then they fail in Selenium. Driver, I will be covering all the kinds of topics, object identification, then dynamic objects, dynamic IDs, frames, web tables, handling the various movements, CSS menus, unit or test engine. Fine. Vikas, for you the voice is breaking. Because the thing is, you need a minimum 100 to 700 kbps internet connection speed. Maybe that's why it is breaking. Yes, it is clear. If my right. So now in Java we have OOPS, WebDriver. Then look, I have not look. The thing is, if you want to share all, if you want to see the detailed topic lists, then they are here. The first 21 modules. You can list down the modules, you can list down the topics of the first 21 modules. These are the detailed topics which I will be covering. Okay, if you want to go in that detail, then these are the first 20, except IDE. I am not covering IDE in this course. IDE is the 10th module. Okay, right, if you want to go through the details, then the first, look at the topics of the first 21 modules. Right. Now, after that, after JSONG, we'll move over to frameworks. Okay, so this is the high level design which I have told you. If you want to look at the detailed topics, then look at the topics under these training videos. Right. Now, Flash FlexBase automation with Selenium. It is, first of all, it is possible. It is possible to automate FlexBase application. Only thing is, you should be having the code or the API of that FlashBase application exposed. A very simple example to you, you cannot go and simply automate any FlashBase application on the web. On the web, if there is a FlashBase application, you cannot go and automate it. You need to have the API or the code exposed for that automation. For example, a very simple example is YouTube. YouTube has videos, fine, and YouTube has exposed the API or the functions for those videos to everybody. So I can automate YouTube videos with Selenium, and I have done that successfully. If you look at this section over here, flash testing with Selenium on the top, you'll see that I have explained, I have taken a lot of flash based applications and I have explained how to automate. Fine, so it is possible, but it is a little bit tricky. It's not so simple, right? Mobile automation, well, there are two drivers in Selenium, in the web driver, called as Android drivers and iPhone driver. So Android and iPhone drivers, these are the two drivers, but they are not so stable. Okay, I have personally used them, they are not so stable. Probably in some releases they will be stable, because these things, they keep on changing the OS versions and all, Gingerbread comes up or something like that comes up. So it's not so stable. Even the creators of Selenium, they in, I was hearing a conference and they were also saying that something or the other breaks and all. So it's not so stable, although you can do it. But remember, you cannot test any mobile based application for this. It is only for browsers. You can test how your website is opening in browsers. You cannot test applications. You cannot test a game. Right? Selenium is for automation of browsers. It's a browser automation tool. Right? No. Right? So only for browsers. Okay. So now the next question, model windows autocomplete. Yes, you can handle model windows, but you have to use a tool like autocomplete. Selenium has got nothing which can handle those. So you have to use autocomplete. What do you mean by model windows? Sometimes if you have worked on servers, if you directly hit the server, you get a window asking for the server username and password. So that's known as a model window. It's more of a window based thing. So you cannot do it with Selenium, but you have to use a tool called autocomplete. Right? I'll give you this information. I'll give you this. Right? As far as Selenium and QPP is concerned, okay. Will mobile based automation sample will be, no, I am not, I have not, although I have worked on mobile applications with Selenium, I have not released the mobile based videos till now, just because it is a little unstable. If I release it, then lot of people, they come over to question, with questions with me. Frankly, over 1000 people have registered with me till date. If I release anything which is unstable, then I get spade of questions, spade of emails in my inbox, and I am not able to answer them, right? So I, for example, web driver with Safari. Okay, web driver works good with IE, it works good with Chrome, it works good with Firefox, but it gives issues with Safari. I have not released videos on Safari as of now. If you look at on my website, I have released it with Firefox, I have released it with Chrome, I have released it with IE and all, I have not released it with Safari as of now. Okay, so any guidance to use mobile based browser? Well, the best thing is you can go to this Google and type Selenium Android driver. If you want to learn it, then this guy has given a very good blog over here, which I also follow. Fine. Out here he has given a lot of information about how to configure Selenium. From the very beginning he has explained, right? But I am sure you will get stuck up in some place, because I also got stuck up when I was working for the first time 1 year back. But still I will advise you, wait for some days, let it be stable first, right? After that, Ajax components. Yes, Ajax components are possible. There are many types of Ajax requests, okay, synchronous requests, asynchronous requests and all. For example, sometimes Ajax requests are fired when you click on a page, fine, and sometimes Ajax requests are fired without interacting with the page. For example, a very simple example is Facebook, right? You click on some link and that link and you see an image loading and the Ajax thing comes up in front of you, right? So that is a thing, you can say that that is a Ajax component. But sometimes what happens, your friend, suppose he comments on something else, right? So you instantly get a indication on the top, a red mark telling you that you have got some message or something. So that's an Ajax based component. For example, your inbox, if you have used Gmail, right, without refreshing the inbox, without touching the inbox, a new mail comes up into your inbox. That again comes in with the help of asynchronous Ajax calls. You don't have to interact with the page. You can handle both of them with Selenium. I'll be covering that, yes. And continuous integration with Hudson and Jenkins. Well, I'm sorry, I have not covered this till now. I'm working on it because this thing, when I started making this whole thing 1 year back, I had a plan of 1 to 1.5 years to complete everything. So 1 year is over, I have released 40 modules. Still, I have yet to release modules on Hudson, Jenkins, Fitness, and I need to introduce the QC connection which somebody was talking about, and also Android drivers and all. So a lot of things are left. When I started this website 1 year back, right now there are around 40 modules. It's written 39 over here, but yesterday I released one more module, so there are 40. I'm planning there will be total around 70 modules coming up, 70 in next 6-7 months or 1 year, right? So there's a long way to go. So there are many things which I will be covering up later on, but not right now. Okay. So this is future. I'll be very honest with you. In future, I will cover this. Although I know this, but to release everything professionally, it takes time. CSS menus. Yes, I will be covering this in the syllabus, in the classroom, in the online training. I'll be covering CSS menus. Dynamic IDs. Yes, I'll be covering those as well. What are dynamic IDs? If you know Selenium, then sometimes the object description it changes every time you refresh the page. Okay, so I'll be covering that. Framework designs and approach. Now, this is very important. No, I don't do it with C#. I do it with Java. Okay, I don't teach Selenium with C#. Okay, framework design and approach. Well, framework is a very vast thing. Okay, there's no book on framework. There's no layout on framework. There's no specific entity which controls framework. Okay, what is a framework? First of all, it is the way, the platform on which you will test your applications, right? For example, you have got 10,000 test cases to run, right? Well, I'll talk about that. So this is a very vast thing. I've just given 5 minutes to this. What is Selenium? First of all, suppose these are my Selenium test cases out here. These are my Selenium test cases. The work of Selenium is only to interact with the application. This is my application, web application, and these are suppose 10,000 test cases. They are executing on this particular thing, right? Okay, another question being asked is, do I need to buy WebDriver? No. Selenium is an open source tool. Everything related to Selenium is open source. You don't need to buy anything. Okay, no, nothing. It's an open source tool, right? And I think I missed out on Selenium versus QTP. I'll cover that in just a minute. So what will happen is, if you are running these test cases one by one, okay, you want a particular order in which these test cases, your scripts should execute, fine. Now, Selenium will only interact with browser. How do I run these scripts together? How do I instruct that, fine, therefore this script should execute, then this, then this, then this, right? Again, along with that, we all know that the test data, for example, I need to fill a username and a password while testing the application. You read the test data from an Excel file, fine. Then we need to generate some reports, HTML reports, that which test case passed, which test case failed and all. Then along with that, another important thing which many clients want these days is logging. You need to generate logs. That is, suppose your script runs for say 1 hour, fine. So how will the logging take place, right? What happened at each and every minute, what happened at each and every second, which test case was passing and all, what was exactly the error, Okay, suppose if the script crashes in between, why is it crashing? So everything is in a log file. That's a .txt file or a .log file, whatever it is. It's got the timestamp and the messages, similar to server logs, right? And in order to coordinate with everything, you need to use something in between. Like some people use JUnit, right? Some people use TestNG. Now some people use Fitness, right? So you have to use tools like these. So it's not just that you have to learn Selenium. So this again thing, I told you, right? It's not just because of that. This is Selenium over here. This is Selenium, one in the green box. So you need to integrate Selenium with many things. Okay, and what JUnit does is JUnit will read the data from here, it will call the respective script, then if the script is running successfully or it is failing, it will generate the reports, it will do the logging, right? So this is what a complete framework model is like. Now there are many types of frameworks. There is a data driven framework, there is a hybrid framework, which is a mixture of data and keyword driven. Then there is a page object model concept, right? I just introduced that in the website itself out here. On the 39th, yeah. Okay, which video of yours I need to buy for Selenium WebDriver? Look, when you buy the access to the videos from me, you get access to all the videos. I don't have selected access, frankly. I'm hosting the videos, they don't provide selected access. When you buy, you get access to all the videos. Fine. So that's the history of frameworks. So these are the components of frameworks which I just done. This is a high level description. Fine. So don't think that you just have to learn WebDriver, you have to learn TestNG or JUnit, then you have to learn how to use Java code to write from Excel file, do the reporting, logging, log core the API in Java. So there's a lot of things. So Java is the main thing which many people miss on, right? So right. So I think I gave a little bit of hint on this. Okay, Selenium versus QTP. Well, QTP is a paid tool, Selenium is a free tool. That's the first answer. Second answer is, if you have money with you, go for QTP. Okay, I don't say it's a better tool, but it's more professional. Fine? It's more professional, it's more bent towards the tester. Fine? Because we as testers, we don't have a very good programming background in all. And yes, you have support from HP, obviously. When you're not paying anybody, this is a global fact. If I'm not paying anybody to use Selenium, I cannot catch hold of anybody if this tool is not working fine. But in QTP, if some feature is not working fine, you have something to do. You can go to HP and tell them that fine, your tool has got this effect or something like this. Okay, but overall, if you talk about Selenium, yes, as far as web-based applications are concerned, it can automate the web-based applications, the normal HTML scripts and all quite easily, HTML pages and all, it can automate easily, fine. If you talk about Windows-based applications, then QTP obviously is the only tool. QTP will automate the Windows-based applications as well. And Selenium is available with many programming languages, Java, C Sharp, Ruby, Python, Perl and all, a lot of languages are there. QTP is there with VB script, fine. So this is a general difference I'm telling you. Each tool has its own pros and cons, fine. But if your company has a budget, fine, if you have allotted a certain budget for the testing team and if you're looking out for a testing tool, then I would say there's no need to investigate as well. Don't think whether buy this tool or that tool. Go for QTP, fine. If you're low on a budget, you can Selenium. Selenium supports Applet. Yes, it supports Applet, but it's not so easy. Fine, because Applets are JavaScript based. With JavaScript, you can control Applets. Okay. Suppose it's a simple application like Skype. How will you automate with Selenium? It's next to impossible. It's not possible. Okay. Applets is possible, but again, to automate Applets with Selenium, you need to have the applet code with you, right? That's the thing. Selenium integration with Quality Center. Well, what Quality Center guys did was, if anybody has done QC and you have studied the QC open test architecture, which is known as the OTA. I don't know whether you have studied that or not, but if there is something known as QC OTA, open test architecture. This is the one, QC OTA API. Now what is OTA in Quality Center? I'm assuming what you know what a Quality Center is. It's a bug management tool or a testing lifecycle management tool by HP. It's a paid tool. So what these QTP guys used to do was that they used to integrate QTP with QC. Rather, they do it still now, like they still integrated. QTP does the testing and it reports the bugs in Quality Center. Okay. Now there is an API, QC OTA API, through which you can connect to QC and do anything with QC. Yes, that means your Selenium can be integrated with QC. You can execute QC OTA commands and all. Yes. Okay. I have not taught that, but I know it can be done, right? But I have not taken that as of now. It's in my diary, it's in my plan. So as I told you, I had a plan of 1.5 years for this whole website, out of which I think I have released around 60-65% till now. I started in last year, August. Fine, I released this website last year, August. The videos initially were around 33 hours, now they are over 80 hours. The initial video, the modules were just 21, now there are 40 modules. So I plan to release around 70 modules in next 7-8 months as well. So it will take time, fine. So QC OTA I will be covering later on in my course. Okay, it's an open test architecture which you use with QTP. But being from the QTP background as well, I know that you can use Selenium as well, but I have not covered that. Okay, now other questions being asked are, RC, as I told you, RC I will be covering later on. Like I won't be covering in the course, but in the videos. Right? Database testing with Selenium. Look, Selenium will not do your database testing. It is actually Java which does the database testing. You connect Java with database, okay, and then you pull out the values JDBC and all. Selenium is not for database. Okay, database testing can be done with Java. I have covered database testing modules in my course. Okay. If you go to qtpselenium.com, out here there is Selenium with database testing. If you click on it, you will get the database testing modules. Okay. Then another question, grid. Okay, as I told you, grid is for parallel execution. I have modules for grid as well. Okay, in online training, teaching grid is not possible, frankly, because grid is something which helps you to integrate your test cases and you can run them parallelly on multiple machines. Okay, so you can actually, in online training it becomes difficult because I cannot teach it, but in the videos I have done that on parallel machines and all, and I have done it with very good way using VMware and all everything. Okay. So database testing can only be done with MySQL. Oh, the question is being asked is what all databases are supported for database testing. Well, virtually you can connect any database with Java. It's not just MySQL. You can connect any database with Java. Okay. It's not just MySQL. Okay. So obviously, everybody allows Java to connect to the database. There are drivers. There are drivers for every database. Web services testing using Selenium. Personally, I think it's a very bad idea. Well, when SOAP UI is there, the free version of SOAP UI is there, which is a professional tool for web services testing. Why do you want to use Selenium? That's my question to everybody who comes to me with this question, with this thing, that why do you want to use Selenium, which is a tool for a browser based application. If you go to Google and you just type over here Selenium, and search, I know like we have not started with the course yet, okay, but I will tell you, I'll be starting it in some time, but first let me cover your questions. If you go to the Selenium, it says that Selenium automates browsers. The first line is this. So don't use Selenium for web services. Okay. SOAP UI is a free tool which can be used. Right. Will you cover grid in this course? Well, I will not cover grid in this course. I'll be very honest, because how can I show you parallel execution of test cases on multiple machines? Okay. Architecture of WebDriver and all, yes, I will be telling you in some time. By tomorrow end, you will be knowing architecture of WebDriver. By tomorrow end, end of tomorrow, like, you will be knowing how to download WebDriver and all, everything. Okay. But it's, once I thought of teaching grid in the online course, but it's not so successful. So I don't want to waste time on that. But I have made videos on grid using VMware and all. I have actually physically shown scripts being run on multiple machines. Okay, so you can go through that. Disadvantages of Selenium. Yes, I can show you how to set up grid and all, but ultimately if you just need to learn the setup only, then videos are good enough, right? Yeah, support is there. I have a forum. Okay. I have a forum wherein I ask everybody to join in. Whosoever like joins my course, I ask him to join a forum which I am having. Okay. And in that forum, I have over 500, 600 people. So you can post your questions there and all, and I answer them, and you can actually get your answers over there from myself or any other. You can, for the course fees and all, you can go here to my course, to my website, qtpselenium.com. The question being asked is, what is the course fee? You can go to qtpselenium.com. You can click on register for training over here. The course fees and all, everything is mentioned on the next page. Okay. So, right. Disadvantages of Selenium. Well, you need to learn Java, which most of the people don't want to learn, but that's not a disadvantage. But I tell you, the foremost disadvantage which I feel is that practically, when working on it, if anybody has worked on QTP, then in QTP there is an option run from step. Okay, I'll just tell you. If I have a script, fine. This is my first line of script, this is my second line of script, third line, fourth line, and suppose this is my 100th line. And the error in the script, you are developing the script, the error is coming on the 50th line. Okay. Now in QTP, you have a feature called run from step, where you can execute your code from the 49th step. And then you can immediately, the 50th step executes and you can find the error, where the error is, right? So this helps you a lot. This makes your work very easy. But in Selenium, you need to execute the script from the very beginning again. So what will happen is, from the very beginning, the browser will again open. In the second line, maybe you will log in into the application. After logging in, you will do something. Then you will navigate through the pages. And then the control will come over to the 50th page, and where the error was coming. So this makes the whole thing very tedious, because obviously when you are writing big code and all, then you will have to make mistakes. So this is one of the drawbacks which I feel is the major one. and I don't think so there is any way to fix this. But in QTP, you can actually instruct QTP to run the script from the 40th, 49th line or so. It's quick. It makes your work very quick. Right? So that's one of the disadvantages. Then again, it is more programmatically, like you'll have to bend toward more towards programming in this. But in QTP as well, if you are working with descriptive programming and all, you'll have to bend a lot towards CD scripting. So that discussion can never end, that whether QTP is more having programming skills or Selenium is having programming skills, right? Right. Okay. Ashish and Vikas, I'll explain your questions. Right. Upload window. Yes, you can handle the upload window with Selenium itself. There's nothing to do with. I'll explain you how to handle the upload window, and I will actually show you examples. That is how to upload your Facebook picture and all, and how to upload pictures on the websites. Right. Now, three questions being asked. Can you explain little more, is error handling thing are there in Selenium, right? Error handling thing is not a part of Selenium. Selenium is a tool which will help you to interact with browser. If you have a browser, you have to click on this link on the browser, then Selenium will click on it. If you have to enter something over here, Selenium will enter. If you want to click on this button, Selenium will click on this button. But suppose this link is not present and Selenium fails to click on it. At that time, you need a system like a JUnit or TestNG which will report that Selenium is failing to click on this link and will generate the reports. Selenium will not handle the error. It is JUnit, Java and all which will handle the error. Okay. Second question is, will Selenium support JavaScript? Yes, it does. Okay, I'll talk about this. There's a JavaScript executor through which you can support JavaScript. Is performance testing possible using Selenium? Yes, Satish, performance testing is possible, but again, it's a very bad idea. On Selenium website, there is nowhere that they have told that performance testing is possible with Selenium. Okay, or how to do performance testing with Selenium. Nowhere have they mentioned on the Selenium website. Look, there is a very good tool available for performance testing, and the name of that tool is JMeter. It's an open source tool. Fine. So better go with JMeter. Right? Can we have Selenium script combination of Java and JavaScript code? Yes, you can have, and that's what we have it actually in the projects. Okay. So, right. Okay. Now, many people. Okay, let's start with Selenium now. Okay, and since the questions are coming up on JavaScript, right? I will just tell you what JavaScript is. Fine. Remote machine and all these are parts of grids. Like, so this is. If you're talking about the remote web driver, then let me know, Ashish. Okay. Fine. So, final question is, do you have to get familiar with JavaScript for web driver? It's not mandatory. I'll start with JavaScript. That's why I'm starting with JavaScript. Okay. Can you run Selenium script on Unix, Windows? It depends. For example, Selenium can be integrated with many programming languages. One of them is Java. So that's why it's famous with Java, because Java code is platform independent. You make the script on Windows, you can make it run on Linux or Unix based machines, it is possible. But suppose you are using a language which is not supported in Unix based operating system. So you cannot run the script over there. Okay, you cannot. But in Java, every operating system is supported. It's a platform independent language. You make at one place and run everywhere. Okay, it's like that, right? Okay. Now, fine. I'll tell you what JavaScript is. Fine. JavaScript is a language which all the browsers they understand. It's a browser specific language, and it's something. Just a minute. It is something which is a part and parcel of the browser. Now, in this FAQs questions, I know many people might not have understood many things. So, I just answered questions. If you have not understood things, there is no need to worry. I am going to start from the very basics. I know that in this training, there are people with no programming background, or very little programming background, or there are people who are just out here with a very good Selenium background and they just want to know how things work out there in this training. Fine. So now, let's talk about JavaScript. Now, what is JavaScript? First of all, how are web pages made? A web page is made in a HTML language. Okay. How HTML language works is like this. It's got tags. This is an HTML tag. It's an HTML tag. Then in HTML tag, there's a head tag. Head tag finishes out here. This is a tag. It's like an XML file. Okay. You have a title tag in which you can write your title of the page. This is my page. And then you have a body tag in HTML. The body tag finishes over here. And in this, I can write anything. Test. I'll save this file on the desktop as in double quotes sample.html. Okay? Sample.html. I save it and I get this file over here. Okay? When I open this, just a minute. I think I did not close a tag. Oh. Save it. Okay, it's not getting saved. Hold on. Just a minute. I'll save it in my D drive. I think there's an issue for admin rights on my PC. I am not having admin rights right now. Yeah, this is the file. If you open it with Firefox, you see something weird. I made a mistake. Okay, I have not closed the title tag. Title tag has to be closed. So if you refresh the page, you see that test is written over here, which was inside the body. The body tags, they contain whatever is there in the on the web page. Okay. And title, if you look at the title of this page, the title is "This is my page." Fine. So now this is simple HTML page. Okay. If you write over here input type equals to text, what will happen is when you refresh this page, you will get a text field in which you can write something. So this is how web pages are made. Fine. But if you look at this web page, then there is no programming logic in it. There is no if statement, else statement. I hope you know basically what an if else block is or something like that. So to do this, to introduce the programming logic in the pages, what the developers do, they use JavaScript. Okay, they use JavaScript. For example, you can make a tag like this, script language like this. In this I will write alert hello world. This is a JavaScript command, alert. If you refresh this, you will get a box like this. Now many people out here might have seen this box. Sometimes this is a JavaScript alert box which comes with OK and cancel button and all. So this is the alert box. This is the part of JavaScript. So similarly, if you can fire any JavaScript command, you can write window dot location equals to http://google.com. Fine. So you write like this, and when you refresh your page, hold on, just a minute. The page will navigate to google.com automatically. Okay. So this is how automation tools also work. Behind the scenes, they fire these kinds of commands. Okay. Now with Selenium WebDriver, you will never fire this kind of command, window.location. But what I am trying to tell you, in the heart of Selenium, the core of Selenium is made in JavaScript. These are the types of commands which have been implemented over there. Okay. So what they did was, whosoever made Selenium, they made the core of Selenium using JavaScript. Okay. Because JavaScript is the ultimate thing which will be controlling your browser. I just showed you how to navigate the browser from one page to another automatically with JavaScript. Fine. And what happens is that this JavaScript is not a very simple language. The problem occurs when you make a mistake. Okay. If in my code out here, if I go back to my code, just a minute. If I go back to my code and by chance if I miss this semicolon, then my page will never navigate to google.com, and it will be very tough for me as a tester to debug this code what happened. So this JavaScript, as I was telling you, it's not a very straight through language. It's very difficult to debug and all. So what these guys did, they put a wrapper around it. These Selenium guys, they put a wrapper around JavaScript. I'm just explaining you in a very layman's term. It's not actually a wrapper. And then they ask languages like Java, C sharp, Ruby, Python, Perl, PHP, all these languages. Okay, they made the API available in all the languages. Now, when you use Java, the Java command for navigating to a browser will be different. Suppose I want to navigate to google.com using Selenium. Out there the command to navigate to Google will be different, but in the end that command will be interacting with JavaScript and it will be actually firing the JavaScript function. Similarly with C sharp or Ruby, in the end the commands, they actually fire the JavaScript commands by interacting with the core of Selenium, and you can, this way you can implement Selenium in many languages, because in the end it's the JavaScript command which should be executed. So you can execute it using any programming language, very simple. Now what if Selenium is not working? Suppose I have to click on this link, get the latest from London 2012 Olympic Games. Suppose I need to click on it using Selenium and Selenium is not able to click on this link, what do we do? That's where we integrate JavaScript commands in our Selenium scripts. What we do? We extend the API. Because this is an open source tool, you can extend it. We extend the API and we make our own commands in the core JavaScript. Okay, this will be my own area. This is the area given by the Selenium developers. So you can do that as well. In IDE we do that, in RC we do that, in WebDriver also we do that. Okay. Right. So what we'll do is, now I will be starting off. I just told you why Selenium is there with multiple languages, what JavaScript is. Okay. Now I will be starting with Java. Okay. If you want to learn more about JavaScript,
there's a JavaScript tutorial which I will ask you to go through, because when I come over to JavaScript in Selenium, it will be tough for me to explain you little small JavaScript commands. So I would tell you, I will just simply request you to just go through this tutorial, right? So this will make my work easy. I will be able to concentrate more on the advanced things. Okay, so just go little by little and you'll be able to understand it. It's very simple. Okay, now I'll be starting off with Java language, Java as a language, and I'll explain you about little bit of Selenium as well. Fine. So let's have a break for 5 minutes. Okay, it is 10:05 in the night in India right now. We'll meet at 10:10. Okay, and then I'll start with Java language. Right. Okay. All right.